Hey everyone, it's David with Ash&Ember Woodshop, and today we're going to be talking about doing a ramp test on your OMTech laser. So when you first receive your laser, you're going to want to figure out what the focal distance is from your laser tube to the material that you're going to be engraving or cutting. The way that you do this is through a ramp test. So let's dive into it. So to set up your ramp test, you're going to find something in your shop that can elevate a piece of wood and put it at a slope so you create a ramp. Next, you're gonna lower the bed of the laser so you can bring your nozzle tube over the material. So let's bring the laser over to the material. And now you're gonna want to adjust the laser bed so that laser tube is just almost touching that material. So here you can see that the nozzle tube is almost touching the material, but is not. Okay, now that you have your ramp set up and your nozzle head just barely touching the material, you're gonna go back to your controller and we're gonna set your max power. So for mine, my laser does not fire anything under 10%. But to do your ramp test, let's set your max power to 25%. Now, for the speed, let's set it to 200. So now with that being done, what you're going to do to your ramp test is you're going to, at the same time, hit pulse and the right arrow to bring the nozzle head across your material. Now when this is being done, remember that you'll need to have your water chiller turned on. Okay, now let's fire your pulse. So like I said, while we're hitting pulse and the right arrow at the same time, we'll draw a line. All right, let's do this. Okay, now that your line is drawn, you're gonna go through here to look for where you have the tightest line in regards. So here we have a pretty wide line. At the beginning, it's pretty wide. And as we get down, we get to a very narrow and clean line. So let me zoom in here. And you can see that that line is very narrow and clean. That is going to be our focal distance. So once you find where the narrowest part is of your line test, you're going to mark a line here, and then without moving the ramp, you're going to bring your nozzle head directly over the top of that mark, and you're going to measure from the bottom of your nozzle head to the material, and that will be your focal distance. So now we're going to bring our laser head back over to where that fine line is. And we're going to measure the distance from the laser tube to the material, and that will be your focal distance. So finding the distance between here and here can be a little tricky, and the best way that I've found to do it is either with a scrap piece of material and lining it up to here and then making a mark at the bottom. You can do this with a piece of tape or a piece of paper, and then measuring the distance between here and here with a calipers, a ruler, tape measure, whatever. And you can make yourself a jig of some sort, but that will be your focal distance. Mine so happens to be the width of a AAA battery. So I stick a AAA battery underneath it every time, and that is my focal point. For you, it may be different. And so cutting out a jig on a piece of wood or acrylic with how many millimeters your focal distance is will help tremendously when setting up your laser to be the correct distance from the nozzle head to your project. For me, it happened to be a AAA battery. So now that we've found that distance, we're gonna take our material, we're gonna lay it flat, we're gonna bring our bed up to our new focal distance. So we'll raise our bed here. And once we get to where we think we are, we'll take our jig and come underneath. That was a little high, and bring it down to where that slides underneath. And you're done. Another way of doing it is bringing this to where it is, and then you can actually loosen this. This will slide down on top of, and then you can retighten it. Just a couple different ways of finding your focal distance or adjusting to the focal distance once you're ready to go. But now that you've found your focal distance, you can now cut and engrave and have crisp, tight lines. All right, so that's how you do a ramp test for your OMTech laser. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below. And if you found this useful, please share with your friends, like, and subscribe. Thanks.